Hey everyone, it's Anson, and over the last few weeks, I've put every one of the files that I've worked with into a single folder on my computer. Today, I'm going to show you how I organize files fast using an incredibly powerful, yet often overlooked built-in feature of macOS, smart folders. I have over 300 files in my dump folder. Let's change that to zero. Smart folders are actually just saved filters that allow you to easily access the files that meet your filter criteria later on. So let's create a filter. To make things easier, I'm just going to open up the folder that's my file dump. So you can see right now it has 315 items in here, and you can kind of get an idea of what type of items are in here. There's a lot of images, a lot of movie files, audio files, there's PDFs, Excel files, all sorts of stuff. So let's go ahead and let's start getting this stuff organized. So to create a smart folder from within the folder that I'd like to sort through, I'm going to go up to File and I'm going to click on New Smart Folder. And this actually just starts creating a filter for us. So you'll notice that right now when we start creating a new filter, by default, it's going to search your entire computer, and we want to just search file dump because we don't want to search through files that we've already organized before that are deeper into our file system in the folders that they're supposed to be in. I only want to search the files that I've dumped into this one folder. So with file dump selected, we're going to go over to the right and we're going to click on this plus icon, not that one at the top, but the second one next to the save button. And this is where we can add some more attributes. So notice that in the first dropdown, by default, it says name, but we have a number of different options to choose from. And if you don't see the option that you're looking for, you can click on Other, and a whole list of options appears. And I think this is where hopefully you can start to see how powerful this feature can be because of the amount of options that you have for filtering here on macOS. So I'm going to close this one out for now. And the first thing that I want to do with my dump folder is get all the images out. So I'm going to sort by file extension. And then for now, I'm just going to type in PNG. You'll notice that when I do that, all of the PNG files within my dump folder appear. So now I could actually, if I wanted to, I could just save this smart folder and it would save it so that we could access it over here in the left side of Finder. And whenever we access it, it's going to show all of the PNG files that are within our dump folder. So we can be adding more PNG files and they will appear in our smart folder. That's why it's a smart folder, right? But I actually have a lot of images in my dump folder in addition to PNGs. So I want to create a smart folder that filters all of them at once. So I'm actually about to show you a tried and true macOS Easter egg. So enjoy this one. But we've started creating our filter here, which you kind of need to do. But then what you're going to do is you're going to go back over to this plus button. And instead of clicking it, you're going to hold down the option key. And you'll notice that it changes to three little dots. Now when we click it, it creates this advanced filter for us. So we can actually just delete out our old filter because we're going to create a filter that's beneath this little drop down right here where it says any of the following are true. We could also choose all of the following are true or none of the following. But I want it to be any, and I actually have a list of all the different types of image files that I have in my dump folder. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to choose file extension. And the first one I'm going to add is PNG. But now I'm going to go over here to the right and I'm going to hit the plus icon and I'm going to choose file extension again. This time we'll do JPEG, that's just JPG. But we also have some JPEGs with the full file extension. So let's choose file extension again and enter JPEG. Now the only other type of image file I have is the web page image file. So let's just add that in here. So we'll say file extension is WEBP. So now you'll notice when we look at our list, we can see we have PNGs, we have JPEGs. So we've now created this smart folder. So first of all, what I want to do is I want to save it. So I'm just going to click on the save button up here at the top right. And by default, smart folders are saved in a folder that is technically in your library, you can see right here, and it's called saved searches. And by default on Mac, there is one saved search. It's called PDFs. You might have seen it in the sidebar of Finder. Whenever you click on that PDF button, you're just running an advanced filter to show all the PDFs on your computer. So we can save them in here. That's fine because notice there's also this option that adds it to the sidebar. So it's going to get added over here to the sidebar of Finder. So let's go ahead and let's just call this one dump images because it's not all the images on my computer, but it's all the images that are in my dump folder. So I'll just click save. You'll notice that we now have
this option over here on the sidebar of Finder to go to Dump Images. So if I go to my desktop, I could then click on Dump Images and they all appear again. Now you don't really have to do anything else if you don't want to with your images. You can leave them in the dump folder and just use this Dump Images smart folder when you want to find them. However, what you can also do is you can just create a new folder and we can just call this Images. Now within our Dump Images smart folder, we can just do Command A to select all of the files. And then we can go ahead and drag them over into the images folder. Now we can open up our file dump again, and you'll notice that right off the bat, I have now reduced this down to just over 100 items because I've moved all of the images to their own folder. Now if I started dropping new images in here, we would see them appear in this dump images smart folder, and I could move them back over to the images folder. So it just basically sorts all of your documents for you. And I'm doing it for my dump folder, but you could do this for your entire computer. If you've never organized anything on your computer before, I recommend that you just create smart folders for your entire computer. But let's go ahead and let's create a second smart folder. This one is going to be for videos. So with the file dump open, I'm going to go to File, New Smart Folder. Now I'm going to choose to search the file dump, not the entire Mac. I'm going to go to the right and hit the plus icon. Then I'm just going to hold Option and hit the three little dots, and I'm actually going to delete out this first criteria that came in before we went to the advanced filtering. So now we're just going to say any of the following are true. We want the file extension, and again, we're doing now video files. So I think the only video file, at least that I know of right now, is MP4. And notice that I'm not putting in .mp4. It's just MP4 when you put in the file extension. So that's important to know. So now, what I can do is I can just go ahead and I can save this smart folder and we'll just call it dump videos. So now it's saved over here to the left. And off camera, I actually created a folder for videos. So we'll just select all with Command A and we'll move these into the videos folder. If we open the file dump back up, we're now down to 92 items. Let's sort our audio files. So we're going to do a new folder, call it audio. I'm going to go to File, New Smart Folder, remembering to click on the File Dump option, clicking the plus, holding Option, clicking the three dots, deleting out this very first filter that we don't need. And now I'm going to add my audio file extensions. I'm going to speed it up a little bit since I have a few. Okay, so the audio files that I'm going to filter for are PKF, AIFF, and M4A. Let's go ahead and let's save this smart folder. We'll call it Dump Audio. And we'll go ahead and select all and move them to the audio folder. Opening our file dump back up, you can see we are down to 72 items. One thing I'm noticing is that I actually forgot one of my video file types. So this gives me a great opportunity to show you how to modify a smart folder after the fact. So notice that I have .mov files in here. So let's go ahead and let's click on this dump videos filter. You can see we don't have anything coming up now because we're not filtering for .mov files. So let's right click on it in our Finder sidebar and go to Show Search Criteria. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and we're going to go to the right side, hold Option, click on the first three little dots, and we're going to go ahead and recreate this a little bit. So we're going to say file extension is MP4. We're just going to kind of recreate that initial one. Then we're going to delete the one that was in there. And then we're going to add another one. We're going to say file extension is MOV. And notice that nothing shows up. This happens when you're customizing your smart folders. What we actually need to do is we need to go up here and you'll notice that this little all was put in here to say all of the following are true. Let's delete out the all. And now it says any. We've got MP4 and MOV. We're seeing all those MOVs that we forgot to move earlier. We can go ahead and click save. It will just update that smart folder for us. Now we can go ahead, Command A, and move all of these movies into our video folder. If we go and we open up our file dump again, we're down to 52 items. Now I'm going to go through and I'm going to create some smart folders for the rest of these items, but I'm not going to do it all on camera. I'm going to do some off camera because it's really the same process that we've been doing. But I do want to show you a couple things here. First of all, when we go to create a new smart folder, now I've often been doing it by file extension, but when you look at this list here, there are a number of ways to do this. And one thing that I want to mention is you could do it by name. And if you're working on multiple projects, so let's say, you know, I do a lot of YouTube, right? But then I do projects for other companies. I could make a mental note to remind myself to put YouTube in the file name of every YouTube file that I'm working with and the company name of whatever company I'm working for in the file name of all their files. And then I could just create a filter in here that where the name matches YouTube. And I could have a smart folder just for my YouTube files. I could have a smart folder just for other companies that I work with. You can also do it by last modified date. I know a lot of people use this so that they can either delete files that they haven't been using lately. You can even just search your whole Mac and create a smart folder by last modified date. So you can go in every once in a while and delete out all of those really old files. And then you can also create one by file size. So if we take a look at this for me, if I create file size is greater than, say, 1 gigabyte, you guys probably know if you watch my YouTube, I go through a lot of video files and I shoot in 4K. This is being recorded in 4K. The files are huge. So I have to delete files a lot. So I could go ahead and I could create a smart filter and I could just call this dump large files, right? And then I could actually go in here and I could delete some of these, like this video right here, unsupported Mac. I uploaded that video earlier this week. I don't need to work with that anymore. Command backspace. Bye-bye. Then I could go ahead, command shift backspace to empty the trash. So you can get really creative with these smart folders. And like I said, I'm going to go through and I'm going to get the rest of this sorted and then I'll be back. Here's my smart folder setup for text files. It includes PDF, text files, and SRT. Those are like subtitle files. If I was using like docx files and stuff, I could add that in here as well. Here's my smart folder for data files. It includes CSV and XLSX files. This is my smart folder for design files. This is an important one for me because I work with a lot of these types of files, but I don't work with them in mass. So there's usually just one or two of them floating around in there, and I always have trouble finding it. So this includes Adobe Illustrator files, Photoshop files, SVG vector files, and Keynote files, since I do some design in Keynote. All right, everyone, so I've gone through and I only have 5 files left. I have a couple of what I call crap files, right? This DMG file, I don't need that. I've already installed that. Delete this app file. I don't need that app on this computer. I was testing it. I can delete. And then I have this JSON file, which I don't need. I can delete. And then I have these 2 audio files. So it's AIF and WAV. There it is. So we'll just go ahead and we will save this smart folder, select these all, move them over to audio, open up the file dump, and oh, it's empty. We did it. We've gone through every single file in the file dump. Well, we didn't go through every single one individually. We used smart folders to do it. Look how many windows I have open. But now I've gone from 330 files to 7 folders. And let's, for example, open up the images folder. This just looks so much nicer. It is only images. Look at that. I can now easily go through all of these files whenever I need to. And as I'm working, if I'm doing another week of crazy video production, I can throw all my files into this file dump. And then when it goes time to sorting them, I can just go over here and I can choose the different smart folders that I've created in the side of Finder and easily find those folders to move to their proper locations.
So there you have it. That's how I organize my files using smart folders. In just a few minutes, I went from over 330 files down to 0, and I set myself up to more easily organize and sort through them moving forward. I hope that you can find some creative ways to use this feature based on your own workflows and the filter options available. I just went over the easiest way to organize files on macOS, but if you want to know the best way to organize and snap windows to different parts of your display on macOS, check out this video right here where I highlight the free open source macOS window snapping utility called Rectangle. If you enjoyed the video that you're watching right now, I'd really appreciate a thumbs up here on YouTube. Subscribe for more Mac tutorials. Have fun finally getting those files sorted. I'm Anton Alexander, and I will see you in the next one.